kinematics of motion in a straight line. Displacement, velocity, acceleration, and time are related by the equations of uniformly accelerated motion. The equations are v equal to u plus at, v square equal to u square plus 2as, s equal to half of u plus v multiplied by t, s equal to ut plus half at square, and s will also be equal to vt minus half at square, where u is the initial velocity. And v is the final velocity. A is the acceleration. S is the distance or the displacement. And t is the time. First question. From a standing start, a cyclist wins a sprint race in 40 seconds. She has a constant acceleration of 0.5 meter per second square. A part, how fast was she traveling when she crossed the finish line? B, what distance was the race? Now in our first question, we are given that the initial velocity is 0 meter per second and the time is 40 seconds and the acceleration is 0.5 meter per second squared, and we have to find our final velocity. So we can use our formula for the A part. V will be equal to u plus at. Just we'll substitute our values. 0 plus a is 0.5 into 40. So this will give us 20 meter per second. In the same way for the B part, we have to calculate the distance traveled. So s equal to ut plus half at square. So when we substitute it, s equal to 0 into 40 plus half into 0.5 into 40 squared, so which will give us 400 meters. The second question, after a windy night, a road has a pile of debris blocking the way. A motorist driving towards the debris notices it when he is 80 meter away, traveling at 20 meter per second and with a constant acceleration of 2 meter per second square. As soon as he engages the brakes, he will decelerate at a constant rate of 4 meter per second squared. First part A, if the motorist reacts immediately, how far from the debris will he stop? B part, if he takes 2 seconds to react, at what speed will he be driving when he crashes into the debris? For our A part, we are given with the initial velocity 20 meter per second and it is a deceleration, so our acceleration will be equal to minus 4 meter per second squared and our final velocity is 0 meter per second. So now v square will be equal to u square plus 2as. So 0 square equal to 20 square plus 2 into minus 4 into s. So when we simplify, we get a value for s as 50 meters. As the debris is 80 meter away, he will stop at 80 minus 50, that is at 30 meters from the debris. Then for our B part, u equal to 20 meter per second, a equal to 2 meter per second square, and t equal to 2 seconds. So now our v will be equal to u plus 80, so it is 20 plus 2 multiplied by 2, so it is 24 meter per second. Now the distance s will be equal to ut plus half at square. So it will be 20 into 2 plus half into 2 into 2 square. So it will be equal to 44 meters. Therefore, the distance from the debris is 80 minus 44 equal to 36 meters. So now our initial velocity is 24 meter per second and acceleration is decelerating, so minus 4 meter per second squared and the distance is 36 meters, which you have got over here. We need to calculate the speed. So v square equal to u square plus 2as. So it will be equal to 24 square plus 2 into minus 4 into 36. That will be equal to 288. So v will be equal to square root of 288. that will be equal to 17.0 meters. A stone is dropped from the top of a castle. One second later, another stone is thrown downwards from the same place at 14 meters per second. Given that both the stones hit the ground at the same time, find the height of the castle. In the question, the first stone is dropped from the top and the second stone is thrown from the top of the castle one second later. So now let us write the information of what is given for the first stone. First stone we are given with initial velocity is 0 meter per second. And then the height, we'll take it as h meters. That is the distance over here. So t will be equal to t seconds. Now s equal to ut plus half at square. That is h will be equal to 0 into t plus half into 10 into t square. That is h will be equal to 5 t square. Let this be our first equation. Now for our second stone, initially itself we are using it is thrown. So the speed is 14 meter per second and a is 10 meter per second square and s equal to h meters. But t will be equal to t minus 1. According to this time, 1 second later we are throwing. So it is t will be equal to t minus 1 second. So now our s will be equal to ut plus half at square. So s is nothing but a h. And here it is 14 into our time is t minus 1 plus half into 10 into t minus 1 the whole squared. So this will be 14 into t minus 1 plus 5 into t square minus 2t plus 1. So it will be 14t minus 14 plus 5t square minus 10t plus 5. So our h will be equal to, when we simplified, 14 minus 10 is 4t minus 9 plus 5t square. This be our second equation. So now both the equations are equal to h. So we can equate the two equations. So it will be 5t square will be equal to 4t minus 9 plus 5t square. So when we shift it over here, this 5t square and 5t square get cancelled. So 4t will be equal to 9. T will be equal to 9 over 4. That is 2.25 seconds. And now to find the height of the castle. H will be equal to 5t square. So 5 into 2.25 square. That will be equal to 25.3 meters, which is the height of the castle. Therefore, the height of the castle is 25.3 meters. The fourth question. A golf ball is thrown vertically upwards from the ground with a velocity of 43 meters per second. For how long is the golf ball more than 90 meters above the ground? For the fourth question, let us write out the information which is given. So initial velocity is u equal to 43 meter per second and a equal to minus 10 meter per second squared because we are throwing the ball upward. So minus 10 and then s will be equal to 90 meters. We have to find the value of the time. So s equal to ut plus half at squared. So 90 will be equal to 43 into t plus half into minus 10 into t square. So when we simplify this, we get it as 5t square minus 43t plus 90 equal to 0. We can use our quadratic formula minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So we get our answers as 18.5 or 5. That will be equal to 3.6 seconds or 5 seconds. So the ball reaches a distance of 90 meters when it is 3.5 seconds. Then it goes above 90 meters. Then again comes back to 90 meters at 5 seconds. Therefore, the ball is more than 90 meters above the ground for 5 minus 3.6. That will be equal to 1.4 seconds. Fifth question, a weight is pulled vertically upwards from rest with acceleration of 0.8 meter per second squared by a rope from the top of a table. After force against the rope snaps, at which point the weight travels only under the influence of gravity. How long after the rope snaps does the weight return to the table? Now in the first part of the question, when pulled by the rope, we have Ru equal to 0 meter per second and A equal to 0.8 meter per second square and T equal to 4 seconds. We need to calculate S and the final velocity. So now our V will be equal to, that is our final velocity, U plus AT, that is 0 plus 0.8 into 4, that is 3.2 meter per second. And our distance is equal to ut plus half at squared. So it is 0 into 4 plus half into 0.8 into 4 squared, which is equal to 6.4. So the rope moves 6.4 meters with a speed of 3.2 meter per second. Now when the rope snaps, u will be equal to 3.2 meter per second, a equal to minus 10 meter per second squared. And S equal to minus 6.4 meters. And we need to find our time T. So V square equal to U square plus 2AS. So when we substitute it, it is 3.2 square plus 2 into minus 10 into minus 6.4. So when we simplify this, we get it as 138.24. So V equal to square root of 138.24, which will be equal to 11.8 meter per second square. Now our V will be equal to minus 11.8 meter per second square and our U equal to 3.2 meter per second and our acceleration is minus 10 meter per second square. So V equal to U plus AT, our V is minus 11.8 will be equal to 3.2. Minus 10 into t. So 10t will be equal to 15, which implies t will be equal to 1.5 seconds. So in these questions, first you need to write whatever is given and then using that idea, then see which formula you can apply and then use the formula which is necessary to find the unknown quantities. Thank you.